intensity.
Realistically, we're out there trying to kill each other.
When I play to lose. Wish I could walk in someone else's shoes.
The minutes just drag. I'm miles high and I wanna come back. These eyes are cracked all wide, flaring down at the world outside. I got 30 seconds. I gotta get direction. I got 30 seconds till sunrise. Till sunrise.
Who was it you wished to speak to?
This is the time of year when the air is clear and the hills look as if they've been burnished in gold.
Who was it you wished to speak to?
Hurt my ass. I'm not gonna lie. I don't know how, but it hurt my ass.
I'm a contract killer.
I'm a contract killer.
And I'm a contract killer.
I'm a contract killer.
Contract killer.
I'm a contract killer.
Contract killer.
Contract killer.
Contract killer. It's a paid professional. I think most professionals, they should be paid. Basically doing clinics with pro players. We're here in Oahu, and we're teaching kids who would never get a chance to play, but only see videos. They never get to experience to see a pro player in action.
They were just so glad that we were there to hang out and kick it and just talk to them about the sport and what we were doing.
Kind of weird, because I don't feel like I'm anybody special, but they seem to think so.
I got my hybrid cert signed by all the kids that were there.
You really have kids out there that really want to be a part of what you do because they respect what you do.
They wanted to meet us and talk to us and ask us all these questions. It was pretty cool.
This trip basically has been the best trip of with paintball I've ever been on.
We're out here in Hawaii, just having a good time, teaching some kids how to play a little paintball.
Those guys are really good. I mean, they're real. Ready to listen, accept any advice he gave you. I mean, they'd ask questions, be specific, and you could just help them out, and they seemed really willing to learn.
You know, some running, shooting, basic gun skills, trying to get their minds open so they can kick the shit out of us in a few years.
The guy in the bunker's gonna put you in, shoot the opening, because what he's doing is forcing you in to go to the next spot.
Hawaii's an unbelievable place, you know. Not many chances for myself, being where I live, way up north, that you get a chance to see, you know, sites like this and do things like this. So it's a great opportunity that these guys are taking us out and doing this. And it sounds like we're going to do a lot more things.
At the beginning of the year, I didn't really know where I wanted to be. You know, Zach and Bob done a lot for me. They got me started in pro. They seen something in me. So it was tough leaving. It's just what happened there is where I used to live was very far up north, like Northwest Territories almost, way up in the boondocks. And my job there was going to cut back my paintball. They said, either you're working or you're playing paintball. And I said, I just got started, you know, really getting into the zone and being where I wanted to be. So I was like, nah, this is bullshit. I'm out of here. This year, even playing on Oakland, a young group of kids was in the city I moved to, and they were looking to do, to do some big things and to try to get that pro spot. It gave me an opportunity to take seven kids from Canada, Danny Miller and Anthony, and a couple of the Canadian pros, and try to do an all-Canadian thing, right?
We'll be right back.
stuff and be able to pass it on, because we'll get old and die.
But we're lucky that we are contract killers, that we get to go to places like that, because Chris wants to get us out there, get our name out there, and get the players out there. It's nice, you know, it makes you feel good when you have a 12, 14-year-old kid come up and ask for your autograph. But
Josh Davey, I'm a contract killer.
He's gonna put you in and just shoot right here.
And that player that up there, he won't look up there. He's looking.
I do a lot of clinics back at home. I do a lot in Vancouver, British Columbia. I know I'm not gonna be around forever, but I like to groom a lot of kids. So it's definitely real cool to see when the kids that you train come to that national level and excel. It's real rewarding for me.
He has his own unique personality on and off the field. And seriously, when he's all on the field, he's a completely different dude.
I'm not really an angry person in regular day-to-day life, so I don't know. It's that crazy adrenaline rush you get from that sport, and then when something bad happens, it just a switch flicks in my head, and I go crazy. It's not like I try to really control it, because it's what drives me on the field to be aggressive and, you know, and to play hard and stuff. I have to use that anger.
When you see him chuck his gun, or, you know, he smash his hopper like, you know, and then just smash it, bam, you know, forget about it. That's not Tyler.
Realistically, we're out there trying to kill each other and, you know, inflict pain on each other and stuff. So sometimes it's real hard to, you know, control yourself.
Contract Killer is a group of select individuals that proved themselves over the years as being specialized players and impact players. It's a proven bunch of guys that know how to get the business done and handle it on the field. Dynasty is kind of the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life. Had a lot of opportunities to make some money on other teams and stuff, but definitely chosen to stick with a bunch of guys that know how to win. It's truly a good niche of guys that really get along and have the same objective of winning every tournament that they play in. I don't see myself going anywhere else. Todd and Micho, and I'm a contract killer.
Oh, I'm shot in my face. Hold on, let me rub this off.
Yeah, I got shot a lot. I wasn't on my A game. It's embarrassing in front of all those 12-year-old kids.
With execution style like that.
Tyler Humphrey, that dude's wild Benini. Yeah, man, that dude, he goes, I don't know how, where he gets it from, I can't tell, you can't tell that dude's serious. You can't tell if he's serious, if he's bullshitting around, or that's just the way it is.
Tyler Humphrey's, he's funny, that kid's my man. He's, I'll go out with him anywhere, anytime, just party, because it's going to be a good time.
The only words I heard out of him, you know, the whole trip were,
Aloha! Aloha, Tyler.
I thought it was funny. They don't really draw it out quite as much as I do. It's more of an hello, ha.
Anyways, hi, hello, ha, hello, ha.
Hello, hello, ha, hello, ha, hello, ha.
Contract killer. We're rough, we're mean, we're lean, we're animals out here in the wild world of paintball. Drink a toast for those who died, remember well to paint the eye. Sure it's easy to get in, but where's your sense of pride? If you have time to have regrets, certainly you can have respect for those who struggle ceaselessly in the deadly civil war. You wonder now of what I speak, joys and sorrow that having real. It also means goodbye in Hawaiian language. So, that was it.
We went to the Gracie School of Jiu-Jitsu to try and learn some stuff.
Oh yeah, that was fun. There was a guy, Holland Gracie. I guess he's a professional fighter. I mean, he pretty much beat everybody up, but
I guess if I'm gonna get my ass kicked, might as well get my ass kicked by somebody who does it for a living. I prefer to run through the winter chill. Shortcuts are sold in a little pill. Sing songs of the drug lords and the avenues. Hope my life doesn't end way too soon. And then the springtime will always seem so worthy.
We all went out, got our butts whipped by the Gracie, and it was pretty fun. That was a cool experience.
I got to beat up Josh Davey, so that was fun. It was really easy.
And I cheated. And that bathing suit, it just threw me off, right? I went into that fight looking at him in a pink bathing suit, thinking he was a pussy. And after I got out of my rear naked choke, trying to catch my breath, I found out he was a collegiate state wrestler of some sort. What a...
I knew we had a card in the bag when we had Nicky Vegas in there. Nicky Vegas is the only dude that when everybody else is getting their ass whooped, he went in and started putting on the dude a little bit, and the dude was like, okay. What are we supposed to do?
What are we supposed to do? Yeah, he body slammed me. Luckily, it didn't kick my ass too bad.
I've dabbled in the sport a little bit before. Like when I was turning pro playing with paintball, one of my best friends, we were doing mixed martial arts together, jiu-jitsu, and it was kind of like I had a toss-up between where I wanted to go, what direction, and I chose paintball.
Nicky Vegas, yeah. Nicky Vegas is crazy. He's a lunatic. I would never say nothing bad about Nicky Vegas, you know. That he's big and he crazy. You know,
Nicky Vegas is quite an unlucky person, actually, for whatever reason. Anything he seems to be trying to do, like he'll say something and no one will even respond to it, and then someone else will say something, exact same thing, and they'll be like, oh yeah, that's a good idea.
A lot of times, you know, people think professional paintball players live this rock star life, and we really don't.
So up Roy, he finally scrounged some money together and bought a nice brand new car, and one of his buddies, Jesse, breaks it instantly. So you sum up Roy by saying he's even more unlucky than Vegas.
If he wouldn't just be a bitch on toe injuries, he's talking about turf toe and walking around like a little homo.
He'd be like, hey Roy, how you doing? I broke my toe. I just got evicted from my house. I'm living out of a trash sack. That sums up Roy pretty good for that.
Roy is just, you know, you see him, you just have to kick him. You know what I mean? And when he's down, you just kind of got to kick him again.
A lot of times you're living, you know, week by week on what you can afford. You know, if you can go out to dinner, if you got to, you know, buy some top ramen.
I become a contract killer and live out of a plastic garbage bag. My name is Roy.
I love what I do. I love playing paintball. I love the fact that I get to travel around the world and shoot people.
In general, to me, it's a mindset. It's psychological. You got to go out there thinking you're a bad motherfucker. You need to go out there and do your job, you know, and just take these, you know, murder people. Displace me, erase me. It won't go away. And then I wind up higher. You're fresh and ready. I don't want to play in the so-called run of the games. We're making up our That's what contract kill is all about. It's being yourself, going out there, it's playing with a lot of heart, a lot of rage, and just taking it out on the people on the other side of the field.
Success was definitely a grinded out team. You know, I think that's why we're on top right now, is because of the pure and simple fact that we work really, really hard.
Oh, night, sucker.
I shoot someone and they're pissed off.
All day, baby.
Mug you in the face. Playing in the streets of New York. Talking shit.
It's like having a six-year-old kid that idolizes you, and everything that you do, he copies you.
He's known to be a shit talker. He causes a lot of problems.
I enjoy it. It brings a smile to my face and my mother's face.
Totally tries to do anything I'm on the field doing. He wants to do it. It's like, hey, I'm going to play the snake today. I want to play the snake today. That's pretty much how Nicky Cuby is.
John Richardson, also known as Uncle Touch.
It's like a lost child. He's just like wandering around. He doesn't know how to talk yet.
A lot of excessive came from the original Iron Man team. And that team was known for like their emotion, their heart, their passion for the game. And they're like, it's like a family, a big brotherhood. So they're always yelling at each other, angry. This person mad at this person. Like the teams I came for are more, it's just like a party. Get to an event, everything comes together, and we just go pound on people. That's pretty much how it is.
When luck be a lady in a district of red lights, truth is a whisper in a concert of dead mics. I said, right, options are limited, got a predicament. Let me stop and think of it and figure out a witnesses. The one who masqueraded as a man of steel. Behind the curtain, he sips on his chamomile. While dancing on banana peels, a cancer that he can't reveal. Will cancel any chance he had to stand upon his damaged heel. Xanax pills kill the panic till he managed real feelings. So one stuffing depression for the prime queen. He built an arc with the head of a boy to sort in disorders and interpretations of what these songs mean. 16. I learned it isn't difficult to
I get paid, you know, I get paid to play paintball, do what I love. I'm not cocky, I'm just a confident player, and I'll back it up on the field.
Well, don't hold your breath, baby, cause I found a cure. The Buddhist monks kill the Himalaya mountains for. The clouds are torn and have been shattered to dust. And I'm scattering cups of ashes where the passion had rust. And as a sapling, I was good at Catholic looking for my Nazareth. And nowadays, I couldn't get a raise if I was Lazarus. And ain't the half of it, adjectives couldn't capture it. The cat that searched the sea of Asterisk to find a Capulet. I ain't happy yet, they said chill. But they're leaving, I said, and I will. I heard that blood and oil sound the same when they're spilled. Kind of like the promises from those who claim to rebuild. Well, it's a revival.
I'm not like an outspoken or kind of loud, showboating kind of guy. So all the teams I played for all my life, I guess I'm kind of, other people have gotten more limelight than I have. It's nice to see that people recognize that I'm a decent paintball player.
Feminine templates, living at Penn State, getting an F grade whenever she menstruates. I was busy paying the dues to become an artist, and my friends are busy cutting the rug and munching the carpet. That's fine, but after an album of whack lines, I decided to make this music more than a pastime. Too many alchemists have miscounted the calculus, I stumbled on a power trip, or showed the crowd the cowardice. Staying alive in a do or die world, where clarity is cable and angels are suicide girls.
Quincy's one of those players that, you know, he does a really good job making you forget about him.
I gotta do what I gotta do to play the sport.
And he'll make you pay for it. He's a very consistent player.
If I don't play paintball, then I'm pretty much just nothing.
I think Dynasty's very lucky to actually be able to pick him up.
It doesn't matter who's on the opposite side. So I'll, you know, try to blow their face off.
Just modestly scrape the sky, I'm as awake as I can be. Infinite against the world, what a rivalry. My natural habitat and place of birth are unknown. Try knocking on the front door, but no one's home. The resident has taken flight through rhyme. My bright headlights shine, speeding through light blue lines. I'm trapped in the middle of sentences like plane delays. I'm trying to teach these puppies how to obey. Okay, here's a gift, it's a fifth of Jack Daniels. I'm
can't play football in college. I can't play basketball. I'm too short. But paintball, you don't need all that, you know? You just need the smarts and the ability to do your job. Change your identity, pray at Holy Trinity. Train skillfully, hit backs like Trinidad. The beat is my chap, my pen and my pad. Let's go! Let's go!
Mental preparation for any professional sport is 90% of the game.
Three tournament fields set up. We're gonna have one main like arena, like my own, my very own little paintball stadium. Just like Field of Dreams, you know. I wanted to build it, you know, so I can finally have that park where I can go play. You know, so we're gonna have one like main field, a separate field for just X ball, separate field for just seven man.
I was like, that dude got my Derder logo all dirty. So I had to wipe it off. Wiped it clean. I mean, I had nothing to do with the fact that I got shot. You know, I'm cheap.
He didn't cheat, he was wiping off Derder logo.
The dude got paint on my Derder logo, so I had to.
It's not actually a cheat.
You know, the better teams that you practice, you know, the better you're gonna get. You know, you can go out there and get beat down all day, you know, but it's your responsibility to go out there and, you know, play these good teams, take your beatings, and then, you know, to go back and figure out why. It's fun just to hang out with these kids, you know, and, you know, try and be a positive influence on them, you know, at the same time, you know, have a good time playing paintball and whatnot.
Let's go, right, left, right. Right, left, right.
You ain't gotta go full speed, guys. Make sure you get the kill.
Left.
Down on him. Make sure you get the kill. Then move to the third guy. If you miss the first one, he's gonna shoot. You're not making it past him. Make sure you get the kill.
When I first came on the team, you know, I thought our attitudes would clash. You know, I mean, I'm kind of a relaxed guy. You know, I just kind of get in, get my work done, and get out. Eric's real vocal about what he does on the field, but I think it's just. It's every paintball player's emotions. It's just he's more vocal about it.
He was like, I don't even know if I'm going to be able to play for Philly. You know, that Dearman guy, he's such a, you know, and, you know, he's such a, this, that, whatever. You know, he never met me or talked to me, and he hated me. But, once you get on the team, you realize I'm nothing like everybody says I am.
He's real different when you get to know him. If you don't know him, you don't like him because you see him. He's real arrogant. But when you get to know him, I mean, he'll do anything for his friends.
I'd rather everyone hate me. That's fine with me. You know, especially on my other team. Like, I don't go around trying to make friends, cause I'm out here to play. You know, this is what I do to make money. You know, and if you can't respect that, then, you know, why are you in this game anyway?
Yeah, he's crazy out there. He's bobbing around, up, down, around. You don't know. He doesn't know what he's doing. He seems like everybody comes through, gets kills. Next thing you know, he's on the other end of the field, and you look around the bunker and you just shout everybody out.
Maybe I'm a little more flashy or talk shit when I play, or just get into it a lot more, or. Maybe people didn't like the first 2 years in XO when we beat them down. I really don't know if people don't like me. Comments like that, you know, who knows? Maybe I'm an unlikable guy, but it's part of the game. So whatever, you know, that kind of stuff just pushes me further.
I don't know. It's crazy, you know, how he's still playing at this level. The age he is. I think he has a son my age.
I'm not one of the younger guys in the league. A lot of people think I am, but you know, I'm 31 years old, and Todd kind of motivates me, you know, to see somebody who's played paintball that long and to still have passion for that game.
He's won probably more tournaments than all of us on the team combined.
The exact same thing that paintball players do when they first get in the sport. It's just 20 years later, 30 years, 40, I don't even know how old that guy is anymore, but you know, he still has that same passion. And I mean, I don't know, he'll probably be out there in a walker one day still trying to shoot his gun.
If I'm up the middle or, you know, wherever on the right, or, you know, J-Tro or Todd, you know, always rolling their guns, communicating, talking it up, just making plays happen. Because without them, you know, me and Tim and Gerald, we wouldn't get any kills anyways.
Yeah, that guy, he's a good back player, right? He just, you know, he shoots people on the break all the time. You know, he's in there tough. I mean, he gets in there tight when he has to, and he can definitely control the game.
He's an incredible paintball player, and as big as he is, man, he's as quick as a cat.
The FBI, the Anti-American Committee, the Bank of America, Chase Manhattan, none of these people scare me. What scares me is that one day my son will ask me, what did you do, Daddy, when the shit was going down?
Contract killer is pretty much anybody who's just out there to just pretty much destroy everybody on the field and just kill as many people as possible and enjoy it while he's doing it.
Do not give this up.
Contract killer is the best players out there, the best player they could get from all the different teams. Best ballers around.
Basically, you're handpicked between all the pro players. You know, you stood out somehow that, you know, they feel that they can use you to promote their company. It felt good, you know, getting asked. I didn't get to go to Hawaii, but you know, I'm sure there'll be other stuff coming.
To me, the signing is a way for them to appreciate what we did, and then the clinic is a way for us to give back, you know, and show our appreciation for them to spend their money and time, you know, to actually want to learn from us.
It's a car wash, it's a car wash.
Always the little guy.
They're the ones that fall asleep first. Little guys squirm in. Next thing they know, full fist up their butthole.
Gerald Garcia is way shorter in person than he looks in the videos. You know, he just, every time I see him, I think he gets shorter.
It's so much fun playing with him because he's so tiny. He's like, he just goes under the paintballs.
I remember the first time I saw him, I was like, man, that little kid's got some wheels on him. But I found out he's like 30 years old or something.
Or he'll be on the 50. He was like, how did he get there? You know, he's so short. You know, he doesn't need to tuck down. He'll be there.
He's the true meaning of a killer. He goes in with a mission to shoot people, and he'll shoot 3, 4, 5 people and get off the field.
I found myself at some point in time making a shitload of money, and I had all the material things that I needed. Nice house, brand new cars, motorcycles, you know, things like that. But I mean, paintball was a passion. You know, when I got into paintball, I'm sure a lot of the top players will tell you it just sucks you in. It's a lifestyle. My name is Gerald Garcia. I'm a proud contract killer. You run from the sky when it falls on you. How do you run from the sky when it falls on you? How do you run from the sky when it falls on you? How do you run from the sky? I thought the last days were the catchphrase. Someone made it to the finish line in the rat race. That may collapse a wall in this glass maze. His artistry is largely seen as passe. Really as bright as rain on this token hero. Time is finished when sky's the limit. Approaching zero. Behold the pale Trojan horse, the form of a vaccine. You know, it's a life-changing experience when you're fortunate enough to get a taste of the big leagues. And there was a point in my life where work and paintball were starting to clash. And I had to make a decision. And no regrets so far. You know, I decided to give designing houses up and take paintball on, and it's been the best thing that I've ever done. When yourself is helpless, it's when the sycophants turn to Jesus. The fetus is drowning in ocean crevices. Subaquatic tumble tunnels turn to defective fallopian tubes. It's a bloodbath, the wrath of greed, the act of God. 2012. How do you run from the sky when it falls on you? How do you run from the sky when it falls on you? How do you run from the sky when it falls on you? How do you run from the sky? When the Colossus comes, crashing through a sky and fire, the earth will quake and mark the end of the prophet's run. The burst and break of the surface will certainly service the birth of opaque pestilent smoke to block the lungs. We knew we'd perish in this future furnace. After all, the truest prophecies are told by those who mold the outcome. A solid mix of dollar mints and talcum tinted tentacles exalt the chaplain of the ashen chasm. Our policy of never reevaluating our policies will give rise to pandemic damages. White lies and red death for the brandishing, a revolution of stillness, the marching of the mannequins. A twisted vision that mimics movements of crippled pigeons. Folding 20s to trees, imitates smoke from bombarded buildings in a fallout shelter future. Extinction will scream from silos. The blood of man will run red, will flood the land. So say your prayers written with false hopes, cause the plague prevails and chokes for the grip that grabs ghosts. Yes, hark the herald angel of death. The peril will mangle and spread till life is just a new name for the dead. You only make so much money, but if you're not happy at the end of the day, if you don't want to get up and go to work, all you think about is paintball. How do you run from the sky? No clouds, there wasn't white, there were no angels flying around. No fire, there wasn't red, there was no antichrist, no Christ. And the night did not ignite into a fiery pit of dog fights and demonic delight. Instead it was quite like a slight ray of light, flashing in seconds barely attainable by sight. In the end human life felt so damn trite, as if there was never a fight or a war. A knife from a sword, a light to abhor. No glory, no delusions of grandeur, no more. How do you run from the sky when there's none left? How do you run from the sky when it swallows you? How do you run from the sky when you're stuck in a treadmill floating in thin air that leads to nowhere? You can't wait, you're shaking. You just want to get back out there and get that shot back and win that next tournament. You can't get that out of your blood. It's a disease.
Little John, I followed him since I was, you know, 16, 17 years old, you know, growing up in the sport, you know, just trying to, you know, watching that guy, seeing what it is to be a professional paintball player and, you know, just a killer, you know what I mean? For him to come to me years later and be like, hey, you know, I want you to be part of this group of killers, you know? It's kind of cool the way things turn out, you know, following him because of, you know, his personality, his attitude, and, you know, the way that he plays the game of paintball, you know?
My name is Jesse Lyon. I'm a contract killer.
Jesse Lyon, he's like my little retired brother. We've been on several teams together.
He's just a really consistent player. He's a killer.
Danny's awesome. Danny started me playing like at a higher level, so I owe a lot to him. We've been friends for the last 6-7 years. So. He's a good guy, he's funny. He's a joker all the time, he's quick-witted. I love him to death. All the guys are great, right? And that's why Chris and John and the whole hybrid crew pick the guys they have, because you know they represent the company well, represent Paintball well, right? They're all top end players. They're all, you know, on and off the field. You got to be that good person, right?
Hey Chris! Danny Miller needs to be cut! I need to be the only Canadian! F*** you, Danny Miller.
No, he's cool.
Josh Davies, f***ing Canadian.
Yeah. Stand here in this corner, spoken down day in California. Climbing these walls.
Just get down! Here it is! Let him just talk small!
John Richardson, also known as Uncle Touch. Ask him about that one next time you see him.
Roy. Roy is totally worthless, actually.
Go ass in my face!
Yes, sir.
Jesus saves on insurance, which in the guy code. My soul is Mr. Clean, my health is nicotine.
We got tattoos. I got a little bitch tattoo when I cry
like a girl. Hi, Mom.
Hey, Roy.
Hi, Roy.
heck is as big as my head, and then he got triangles.
Hawaii, it's great. An island in water. Ooh, about a Gucci wallet.
I think I violated every clause of my excessive contract right now. Once this video's out, I don't have to worry about being cut.
Alpha Nathan Rosen, you mean the outdoors are already back on the room, man, for sabotage. There will be one to be sore for these slides and upon a magnificent. This video is gonna suck ass. It's got me in it. Me.
I've been a contract killer since the beginning. First guy they signed, basically it's a group of guys that are really accomplished in the sport and really, you know how to handle business on the field, and it's definitely a real cool club to be involved with.
Being a contract killer actually means a lot to me. Ever since I started paintball, I knew what goal I had goals in my mind, and I wanted to play in the top league, and to have a company like Hybrid actually appreciate that and acknowledge that and want me to be a part of the family, that to me is it's a big sense of accomplishment.
You're a contract killer, goddammit. Come on, do your thing, Ryan.
For me, it's just, I just feel, grateful because not that many people, they're not that many contract killers, and it's just a unique clique of people, and we go out and just party, have a good time, but we also, dominate on the field and just go out there with the intent of just murdering as many people as possible. And, we all pretty much have the same mindset, but all come from different, walks of life.
Contract killers pretty much embody professional paintball. It's people that are in the grind, people that sacrifice on the field and off the field to get to the top. We're willing to give blood, tears, every ounce of energy we have to get to the top to win. And I think everybody that's contract killer feels the same way.
To me, man, it's basically just, they saw something in all of us, obviously, like individually, that they can market and show to the world that, not all paintball players are a bunch of nerds and dorks, and like we can go out there and rock out and still like do our jobs. And, we all do our day jobs, we all smash heads.
I'm gonna do my best to, represent their company and be the best paintball player that I could be. And that means training, that means doing everything harder than everyone else. When people aren't, watching me do stuff is when I'm working out, when I'm training harder, and hopefully, just getting better than they are.
Put a lot of my time into playing paintball as a professional and achieving something more, each day, pushing a little bit harder, a little bit farther. paintball to, you know, it's more what paintball is to me, you know, just something I love to do, something I love to push, grind, kick the shit out of people, you know.
Chris and Little John are really cool. They take really good care of us, and they just picked us out from all the different teams we play on just because of what we do on the field.
When Chris called me up about Hawaii, I wanted to get on the plane the next day. You know what I mean? A lot of the guys that play in this league, they travel so much, and we don't really get to stop and appreciate where we are. You know, you've got guys that go to Paris and never see anything else other than the paintball field. You know, but going to Hawaii was a chance to kind of stop and really appreciate, you know, Hawaii for what it is.
I was like, I've never been there, and okay.
You know, Hawaii put out a lot of good memories, and I'm not gonna lie, it's definitely well worth losing my job.
You lost your job on that trip?
Yeah, basically the way it happened is Chris Corsino called me up midnight, like, you know, right before taking the flight. He's like, hey, you wanna go to Hawaii? And I was like, yeah, of course. He's like, all right, be on a plane in 8 hours. So hopped on a plane, and when we landed, I called work and I said, hey, bad news, I'm not gonna be in this week. And so they said, all right, have a good time. I got back, and then I handed in my keys. Went my own way. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
You know, on that trip, we got to, you know, get to know these guys a little bit better, you know, and get to see the personalities that, you know, the people from Hybrid saw in these people to try and put this contract killer team together, you know. Got to spend that time together and get to know each other a little bit better, you know, and that's cool because, you know, the reason why I do paintball, you know, is to have fun, travel the world, play the game that we love, you know, and you meet so many different people from so many different places. And to finally, you know, actually get to spend some real time with these people and get to know them more than just, hey, what's cracking, how's it going, you know, and go move on, see them again in a couple months, you know.